Good afternoon, Southwest Florida. I'm Paige Godfrey. This Naples Herald lunch break is sponsored by Conditioned Air, the comfort of people since 1962. This afternoon, we'll tell you about a bomb threat at two public schools in the area, Francis Rooney celebrates his win, and more. Today is Wednesday, August 31st, and this is the lunch break. Despite efforts to convince voters that all was not well under the Mike Scott administration, challenger Stephanie Eller managed to secure slightly over 15% of the vote in Tuesday's GOP primary election. Sheriff Scott, who spoke earlier in the year with the Lee Herald, maintained his conventional campaign approach, utilizing several well-placed billboards to remind his supporters of the upcoming primary election. A steadfast opponent of Second Amendment rights, outspoken regarding the causes of crime in Lee County, Scott freely shares his data-driven opinions with anyone who will listen. It is his conservative and unwavering demeanor that attracts many. The sheriff allowed his nearly three decades of service to his native county speak for him, and will face James Didio on November 8th. Both Skyline Elementary and Challenger Middle School received Wednesday morning bomb threats. Skyline Elementary begins the school day at 7:55 a.m., so as a result, students were evacuated from the building. They have since received an all clear and have returned to class. Challenger Middle's first period doesn't begin until 9:30 a.m., so there was no need to evacuate. The Lee County Sheriff's Office is handling the investigation. According to the Sheriff's Office, both schools were evacuated. The LCSO did an administrative walkthrough and determined that the threat was not credible. The schools were deemed safe and students and staff were permitted to return. An excited multitude of Rooney supporters filled the Estero Room at the Hyatt Regency Coconut Point on primary election evening, all hopeful for an evening of celebration. As returns were broadcast on dual screens, it became evident that Francis Rooney would secure roughly half of the overall votes, and that Chauncey Goss and Dan Bongino would divide the remainder. Rooney thanked his wife, Kathleen, and all of his staff and supporters. And that was the lunch break for today. I'm Paige Godfrey. The lunch break airs Monday through Friday at 12 p.m. right here at NaplesHerald.com. And don't forget to check out our morning report that also airs Monday through Friday at 8 a.m. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow.